Hey, it's Jim Davis on the Buckeye Boy from the Jim Davis Show, weekday mornings 7 to 10 on the Team 101.1 FM here in the Valley, 1340, 1409 Rifle, also 100.1 FM in Montrose, and online all the time at theteam1340.com.
It's like a 30-second intro with all the stations we're on.
I know, it's the ever-growing empire.
I know Dan Patrick likes to say they're on 307 affiliates, we're on four.
They're all ours, but that's okay, though, they're all our stations.
Still four.
Still pretty cool. Also, podcasts at theteam1340.com. Plug for the website. Max and Nikki have done a great job of the website. Lots of JUCO videos on there. And so here we are to kind of recap JUCO a little bit. Congratulations to Jeff Johnson in Chipola, Florida. Jose Caballero, your MVP of the series, the second baseman. Maybe the biggest play of the series wasn't with his bat. Was the diving play at second base that turned back San Jacinto in the championship game. He had a remarkable series. Ronaldo Rivera, the big first baseman, guy that looks like a major league type first baseman around his size. He's 6'6", he's 250, obviously a lot of power as well. Just a fun team to watch. Junior Harding, who pitched a bunch out of the bullpen for Jeff Johnson, had ulcerative colitis just a couple of seasons ago, and just emerged as really a go-to guy. Evan Steele, the great performance he had, Rio. There's just so many great stories in this Junior College World Series.
Yeah, and initially it didn't really look like Chipola was going to have it. I mean, they lost Monday to San Jacinto, and they had to beat them twice coming back on Friday and Saturday night. It's only the fifth time that's happened in the history of the tournament, by the way. The team wins twice in the last two games to take home the title. It's happened twice to San Jacinto now so far. But a lot of great stories with the inning, and you were talking about Jose Caballero, the MVP. He told Greg Wenzel in the post-game interview that as soon as he made that play, they went out and they scored four runs in the next inning, and he's like, we got it. And they did. They ended up beating San Jacinto. They put him into submission, 15-6.
Yeah, Tequan White, who'd been a big run producer for them during the season, really hadn't been doing that until this series, and that's the home run that you referenced, a three-run shot that they gave Chipola their second national championship. And for Tom Arrington and San Jack, Tom loses in the championship game for the sixth time. It's the 10th time all-time for the school. Look, you consider and dwell on, you know, they don't get it done. They don't get it done. I mean, they have won five national championships, none for Tom or Chris Rupp before him. But the fact that they get here every year and they're playing on a Thursday, they're playing on a Friday, they're playing on a Saturday, yeah, they keep coming up as the bridesmaid, but there still has to be some level of a praise and acknowledgement of how tough that is to do year in and year out, and what Tom and Corey Cole and those guys do.
Yeah, 15 top two finishes for San Jacinto all time in 22 trips. And that's only since 84. I mean, they haven't been coming. 84 was their first year. So you have 34 years. 15 of them have been, the season ends on Friday or Saturday night. That's a great run. Yes, they haven't won the championship. You mentioned Tom Arrington, and now twice in the last 7 years, they've lost 18 and 19. But they're in game 18, undefeated, in order to pull off that feat. Not a lot of teams do that.
Yeah, it's remarkable the consistency that San Jacinto North out of Houston, Texas has put together year in and year out. Quick wrap up on Colorado Mesa. The Mavericks, I mean, we're kind of spell their doom. Left on base. I mean, that's going to be 12 against St. Thomas Aquinas. They had 14 against Westchester, the eventual national champions. Yeah, but for Chris Hanks and the Mavericks, with the season Bly Madris had, Kyle Leahy, Kyle Serrano, Jared McDermott, just a great year for the Maverick baseball team to get to be one of the top four teams in the nation in D2 baseball. That's pretty darn impressive.
Yeah, and I really hope that Mavs fans enjoyed this season with Bly Madris, because next week it could end up being his last season.
Probably go to the Major League Baseball.
Bly. We're very funny.
Just not very funny.
No, very funny.
Not very funny. Also, we have a little bet going on. Of course, as we film this, the Rockies will play the first of two against Cleveland. And so we have a little bet. I'm taking some vacation time. Buckeye Boy's going to be gone as well. So on the 20th, whoever wins, we're just doing tonight's game since it's just a two-game series. It's real short. Whoever wins tonight, the Rockies take on the World Series runner-up. I mean, I hate it when I say that. Cleveland Indians. On the 20th on our show, one of us for an hour is going to have to wear our respective hat. Dear God.
It's going to be this one, all the sweat lines. You can see the sweat lines right there. That's just from last night and today.
And see, my hats, my Rockies hats, I wear them, but they're all pretty clean because...
But here's the thing. I don't sweat randomly.
I don't sweat as profusely apparently as you do.
Yeah.
So...
I sweat sitting down. I sweat talking
about really, cheeseburgers. I'm really losing, okay? Because number one, I'm not an Indians fan. You do kind of like the Rockies.
Oh, no, I do like the Rockies. I don't hate the Indians, but I don't... I have it to where
if the Rockies end up winning both games and I have to go to the Metallica concert Wednesday night, I have a Rockies shirt with me just to keep safe. So if I don't go showing up as the losing team.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry. Come on, Rockies, win tonight, please. Keep me from wearing that.
I'm sweating because I'm thinking about tacos.
All right. Anyway, for our show, weekday morning, 7 to 10, join us for the Jim Davis Show online at team1340.com. Podcasts of all of our shows there if you care to take in some of our past fun and frivolity.
Shenanigans,
hijinks, and tomfoolery. The team1340.com.
So, yeah. Go try it!